Hello everyone and thanks for tuning back in. Alessandro the Crypto here. I hope you're all doing fine. So welcome to another episode. We're gonna start straight here into the content because Bitcoin right now is having a confirmed buy signal, and after reaching this $53,000 bottom that we have currently, it looks like that we are gearing up here for a potential move towards $58,500 to also test here this important moving average that we have here. And this is right now also coinciding with our previous support here of this ascending broadening wedge, which now of course could be turning into resistance. So most likely we're gonna see this push here towards this new resistance that we have here, and then of course we're gonna have to see if we are able to break above and start to go towards new all-time highs, or if here we're getting rejected and we potentially gonna see here continuation to the downside to potentially also test here this $52,000 support that we, in theory, we would have here from this previous resistance that we had here in the past. Because if we're gonna lose here this support, then things could start to look very ugly, my friends. That's why we are in a very critical point, and we should see now the price having a big bounce to the upside and also take out this resistance that we have here in theory at around $58,500. So here in Europe, the stock markets are opening in green, and most likely also the US markets are starting in green. So we have everything in favor for a push here to the upside. And if you're trading with my own indicator, as you can see right now, we have a confirmed buy signal in the 3 hour time frame. And as you can see, we came very close here to our target of $52,000 after this breakout out of this ascending broadening wedge. And right now it's just a matter of time, in my opinion, until we're gonna see here an attempt of breaking and also testing here this $58,500. So if you're longing, my friends, then take it with a grain of salt, this long opportunity, because here we could get rejected, and also we are getting a confirmed sell signal in the daily time frame. So usually when this happens, we always see at least a 20 daily moving average retest, and we didn't test it so far. Currently we came very, very close to it, but we didn't test it. And this moving average is also lining up with our main support that we have here right at $52,000, because if we would lose here this support, if we would start to close daily candles below $52,000, we could be in a massive correction here, even down towards $30,000. Which is the beginning of this rising wedge in which we are in right now. And of course we also have some bearish divergences in the daily time frame, and that's why we are currently in a very critical stage. And also we are trending here between the 20 and 9 daily moving average, which of course could indicate that maybe this is the beginning of a major sell-off down towards these targets. But if we are able to maintain this support at $52,000, then I'm pretty confident that here we're going to see continuation to the upside. And this is also what I think could happen here and in the not so distant future, because we're still looking bullish, my friends, and we should expect here continuation to the upside, even though we got here this sell signal. But since we could here have a big bounce at the 20 daily moving average, I think that here we can stay in this upper region and continue to create new all-time highs in the next coming days and weeks. So we are in a critical point. That's why make sure that if you're taking here a long position, that you have low leverage, because we could even drop towards $30,000. So if you open up with a low leverage trade, then your liquidation price will be below 30k, so you should be safe. And of course on the way down you can also add more into your long position if you want to keep up the trade alive. Otherwise, as soon as we are having daily closes below the 20 daily moving average, make sure to put a stop loss or close your trade if we're gonna lose here this support. But everything is looking like that here we're gonna see continuation to the upside, and I think here pretty soon we will start to fight here this resistance that we have of 58,500, and then most likely also break it and continue to the upside. If you're getting here rejected and then here of course also gonna lose the main support of $52,000, then be prepared to see a massive correction. Otherwise of course we're gonna see continuation to the upside, and I also think that most likely we're gonna go higher and create new all-time highs very, very soon, my friends. And the same goes also for Ethereum, because Ethereum is also still above the 20 daily moving average. We're still trading sideways here. So we're just waiting what Bitcoin is doing. I think as soon as Bitcoin is catching up again with this bullish momentum that we still have, then also Ethereum is gonna test here the all-time high of $2,000 and of course also continue to go higher and higher. So the show currently is over on a Bitcoin. That's why I think it's just a matter of time until here we're gonna see continuation to the upside and then hopefully also break this new resistance. And if we have a look into the DXY, you can see that also here we're still trading sideways. But here it looks like that very, very soon, also here we're gonna drop towards the 200 moving average in the 4 hour, right here at $91. And that of course is in favor for the stock market, for the crypto market, for everything when the DXY is falling. And here in the daily time frame, you can also see that here also we got a sell signal, and most likely also here we're gonna go at least down towards the 20 daily moving average here at $91 to test it. And that of course also could lead into a massive pump in the Bitcoin price and overall also everywhere in the stock market and also crypto market. And talking about stock market, let's go over here to Nasdaq, because Nasdaq yesterday closed above the 20 daily moving average. This is what we wanted to see here. And today, most likely, we're gonna confirm this breakout. So if today we're gonna close here above the 20 daily moving average, which currently is looking quite good here, so above $13,000, then I'm expecting also here continuation to the upside. And that, of course, is also bullish for the crypto market, because if Nasdaq is starting to continue to rise here and pump towards new all-time highs, then I'm pretty confident that this will also be in favor for the Bitcoin price. And that's why also here we should expect continuation to the upside. I don't think that this is now a local top and we're gonna start a huge correction. So even though we are right now in a very critical point, I still think we are still looking very bullish and we should expect here a very big move to the upside incoming pretty soon. Latest once we're gonna start to close 4 hour candles above the 20 moving average right here at $58,500. And we can also make here a Fibonacci retracement from this move that we had here from the bottom here at $43,000 up here to the top of around the $62,000. You can see that the Bitcoin price retraced back down here towards the 0.382 Fibonacci retracement right here at $53,800. You can see that we had now 2 4-hour closes above. So that of course is also very bullish, because usually Bitcoin during an uptrend or downtrend always bounces here at the 0.382 Fibonacci retracement or here at the 0.618. And of course, if we would fall here towards the 0.618 Fibonacci retracement at 50K, this would mean that we would lose here the main support of 52,000 and also drop below the 200 moving average in the 4 hour. So we don't want to see that. We want to have the bounce right here at the 0.382 Fibonacci retracement. And this is exactly what we are seeing right now. So if you take this long opportunity, my friends, then make sure to put a stop loss here below $51,000, because if we're gonna drop below this price level and start to close 4 hour candles and even worse daily candles below this price level, then we're most likely gonna see a huge move towards the next price targets down here towards 30K. We maybe then have some bounces somewhere at around 40K or something like that, but this is a bearish pattern that we are in right now, and sooner or later, in my opinion, we will break out here to the downside, unless of course we are able to break out here to the upside, then things will change. But as long as we're staying within this potential rising wedge here and we have some bearish divergences here in the daily time frame, there is still the risk that here we could fall off the cliffs, and then of course we have to target here the 30K area, or maybe even better here the 20 weekly moving average, which currently is here at $34,000. Because even if we have a week down here towards 30K, we then most likely gonna close the week above the 20 weekly moving average here at $34,000 if here we're gonna see a breakout to the downside. So as long as we are within this rising wedge, there is this risk that we could fall towards these price levels down here where the 20 weekly moving average is lining up. But I don't think that we will go lower than that, because Bitcoin during a bull market always respects latest here the 20 weekly moving average as a very strong support. And that's why I don't think that we will ever go way below $34,000 again during this bull market. So I'm telling you this potential bearish case here, just that you have this in your radar, because there is this risk that we could drop down here. I don't think it will happen right now. I still think we have some room left to the upside, but keep that in mind that we are still in this potential rising wedge here. And if this is going to break out to the downside, things could really start to look very, very ugly. And this pattern can only be denied if we are able to take out this resistance up here. Currently, it's here at around $70,000. So if we are seeing here a successful breakout to the upside, then of course we could have a very parabolic move towards our bullish targets between 75 to 100K. So with that said, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up for now, because I want this video to be on YouTube as soon as possible. Also, big shout out to our great crypto trading chat over on Discord. If you want to join our great Discord trading chat, make sure to use the official invitation link that you find down below here in the video description. Once you have clicked it, you have to go here to read first, because you have to click here on this thumbs up button to confirm that you're a human and not a bot. Like this, you have free access to the crypto trading chat. And also, if you want to get access to my own indicator, which is giving you buy and sell signals, you have to contact me here with a private message. And like this, you can get access to this indicator for a small donation. Otherwise, just use here the subscription methods on YouTube. Like this, you also get access to the live stream indicator. And for everyone that is trading over on Femex, we have this trading event going on the 24th of March. So make sure to join this competition. You still have 7 days left to join it. And we are trading in this team here, in this Chinese team, if you want to join our community. I also will be trading with this Chinese guy. So if you want to join us, then make sure to use the link down below here in the video description. And otherwise, also if you need an account over on Bybit, Femex, or also PrimeXBT, where we have this unique co-vesting feature where you can copy trade other successful traders, then use my referral links down below here. With them, you get some extra bonus, and also you support the channel, of course. So hit that like button, my friends, subscribe to the channel. I do daily TA videos, and we're gonna see us all in the next one. Bye.